15 boys. They told us they have a special detail for us. So they took us and they brought us into Auschwitz to the hospital. I didn't know anything about it. And they told us that they're going to do some research, you know. We didn't know what type of research they're going to do. And all of a sudden, we wind up, I mean, in the hospital. They shaved us. And they told us we're going to have surgery. So I, at the time, there was a Polak there. He was a nurse. I told him, what they're going to do to us? He says, don't worry. Everything will be okay. They just got your mark, you first, and the rest of them. I said, what they're going to do? He says, well, they're going to take out one testicle. So I told him why. He says they experienced with it. So as they put me in the hospital, in the surgery room, he told me that it will hurt a little bit. They didn't give me any Novocaine. They just put some kind of a cream on it. And I could see Dr. Mandela in front of my eyes, and he didn't say anything at all to me. The only the guy who I talked to is through this Pollock, to the nurse. He told me it's going to hurt a little bit, but don't worry about it. So as they did the surgery, it started to burn, you know, and they took one testicle out, and they gave me a couple stitches, and they put me back in the barracks. And I was fighting because, you know, not just you try to survive, but then being sick, having surgery, I figure, you know, after the surgery, they're going to take us to the crematorium, just get rid of us. But didn't happen, you know. They put us in the barracks, and about a week later, they told us we can go back to camp. Now, on some of them, they cut both testicles, and on some of them, they even didn't cut, but they put some kind of, what do you call it?
Some kind of chemical? Or?
Well, yeah, some kind of chemical, and they let you go, and then you couldn't even walk next day because everything started burning, you know. You couldn't even walk. And he told me I was very lucky, this Pollock, because with me they just took out one testicle, mm-hmm. and with some of them, both of them, but some of them, they just left it, they just cut it, they did all kinds of experience on it.
What else do you remember about the actual operation? Can you bring us into that room a little bit more?
Well, I was very frightened, crying, you know, and I didn't know exactly what they're going to do, what kind of experience they're going to do with me, and was very frightened, and nothing I could do, just do what they told me to do. And then with the surgery, I mean, I was just grinding my teeth because I could feel everything, you know. And I could see this Dr. Mandela walking around, and he was doing this experience.
What was he like? Did you attempt to talk to him? Or?
No, he wouldn't say anything at all. Just stood there in front of you, you know, and then he performed the surgery. And that's the last time I saw him, because they used to line us up 15 in this, you know, one by one. They did it. And they took us back, put us back in the barracks.
Did you talk to any of those other 14 boys?
Yeah, I did talk to these boys. They explained what they had done to them. And, you know, I told them I lost one. One of them told me he still has his, but they cut it on both sides, you know. And the other one says, I mean, they didn't do anything, just they put some kind of treatment on them and was burning. He couldn't even walk the next day. That's what I remember.